Hello friends, welcome to the first lecture on advanced concrete structures. It's a subject to 7th semester civil engineering, and today we will see the introduction and few basics regarding design of water tanks. So before starting, I would like to introduce myself. I am Professor Amay Kedikar, working in the Department of Civil Engineering, and looking towards the entire syllabus of the subjects, it is a design subject, and quite long designs are here. So we will start up with the water tank, and before actually starting, if we can try to understand the syllabus and scheme. So we can see here that the theory paper is of 80 marks and 20 marks sessional, then 3 hours theory plus 1 tutorial in a week, and total exam duration is 4 hours. So it's quite lengthy, and 4 hours is the total theory duration. And unit number 1, you can see, it deals with the water tank that we are about to see here now by working stress method and IS code method. Alright, so you can see the course outcome also. By learning this subject, a student will able to understand the behavior and failure mode concrete members, then to analyze and apply the results in designing various concrete members of the structures, then to apply the knowledge and skills in practical problems, and last, to understand the relevant software and use in the same in analysis and design of concrete members. Alright, so we will see today the first content, that is a water tank, types of water tank, basic structures and load calculation, basic requirement, all the things. So we will start up with the basics of water tanks. Alright, you can see this unit number 3, 4, 5. Okay, practical scheme is minimum practicals are allowed, 5 designs on the based of above syllabus and 1 problem, okay, and 1 site visit. It's a part of curriculum. All right so unit number 3, 4, 5, and you can see, so 25 internal and 25 external. Okay, so reference books I have highlighted by red color, that is N. Krishna Raju by Advanced Reinforced Concrete Design. Also, I can suggest you to Shah, Karve and Patki, that is the best book, Karve SR and Shah. Alright, and IS code 3370-2009 for the design of water tanks is very essential, and IS 456 is also very essential. Alright, so with the introduction, storage reservoirs and overhead tanks are used to store the water. Basically, water tank is a hydraulic structure. Okay. So liquid petroleum and similar liquids, the force analysis of the reservoir or tanks is about the same irrespective of the chemical nature of the product. Okay, basically the water tank is the hydraulic structure. Okay, so it may be of 3 types: water tank resting on grounds, underground tanks. So we have seen underground tanks in petrol pumps, or even in apartments we have seen the water tanks undergrounds and elevated tanks that we have often seen in our city nearby areas. These are types of that. Then elevated tanks. Alright, these are 3 types. So first one is the tanks resting on ground, then underground tanks, and then elevated tanks. Okay, the tanks may have circular or rectangular cross section. Yes. Again, the tanks are further classified as rectangular tank, circular tank, inch type tank. Okay, we'll see further. Tanks resting on ground and underground may have flat bottom slab, while elevated ones may have flat or conical bottom. Okay, so the types of water tank are classified on the base of, first of all, based on placement of the tank and based on shape. So based on placement, the water tank is classified as resting on the ground, as discussed, underground and elevated. Alright, and again, based on shape of the tank, circular, rectangular, spherical, ends, and colonial at bottom. Alright, colonial bottom. Okay, so this is the detailed classification of the water tank based on the placement on the earth and based on the shape of the water tank. Okay, you can see now. Okay, underground, elevated, on the earth. Okay, you can see that. So these are the best example of all the water tanks covered by the types as per the shapes and types as per the you can see. Okay, as per the base alright, as per the placement, as per the shape. Now okay, now comparison of the water tank based on the shapes. Okay, then first one is rectangular, then circular, then eaves, then pre-stressed tank. Pre-stressed, you know, the tendency used in the concrete where already, you know, develops tension by stretching it, which is pre-stressed. So for rectangular tank, it is applicable for smaller capacities. Okay, we go for rectangular tanks. When there is a small capacity is required to construct, we go for rectangular. We may go for rectangular. Then circular tank, for bigger capacities we go for circular. Capacities in lakhs, you know, the for that we can go for circular. Inst is a special type of tank where it is constructed to reduce the project cost, because lower dome is the construction resist horizontal thrust. Okay, then pre-stress for bigger tanks, pre-stressing is the superior choice, resulting in saving up to 20%. For gallons of liter water to store, we go for pre-stressed tank. Basically, pre-stress concept is when we use tendons that we call reinforcement bar, the stresses is already developed before using in the concrete. Okay, it may be developed by stretching it on both the sides. So now we will focus first of all introduction to water tanks. Okay, especially first one, rectangular. So rectangular tanks are used when the storage capacity is small. As mentioned, as just now we have seen the comparison, then rectangular tanks should be preferably square in the plan form point of view of economy. Selecting a dimension in a square, that is also called as a smart selection, is in designing. Alright, it is also desirable that longer side should not be greater than twice the smaller side. Okay, then moments are caused in two directions of a ball, that is both in horizontal as well as in vertical direction. Exact analysis is difficult and are designed by approximate methods. Okay, when the length of the wall is more in comparison to the height, the moments will mainly in the vertical direction, that is the panel bends as vertical cantilever. Okay, this is all about rectangular water tank. Then the general requirement of rectangular water tank. Concrete should be rich in cement content, that is water cement ratio should be low. The quantity of cement in mix should not be less than 3 kN per meter cube. Again, to keep shrinkage low, the quantity of cement should not exceed 5.3 kN per meter cube. Generally, M30 grade of concrete is used. Okay, and to avoid leakage problem, limit state method of design should be avoided. IS 456-2000 is a silent about permissible stress in direct tension. Hence, from IS 3370, it is a special course for hydraulic structure, it is obvious that guidelines of previous version of IS 456 should be used, which is based on working stress method. Now firstly we have seen the concrete should be impervious, and second, now we have seen crack development. Okay, so due to dimensional movement in concrete on account of temperature and moisture changes, okay, the crack development may be there. Crack development may be due to the differential expansion of the thick member due to the heat of hydration. Okay, crack development due to caused by the unequal settlement of the load. Okay, because in the circular tank we have to, you know, go through the tangential stresses and all that we will see further in detail. Remedial is what to do to avoid this: proper curing, provision of joints, reinforcement in each of two directions at right angles. Then expansion and shrinkage of concrete should be considered during the design. Alright, then subdivide the tank in smaller compartments with provision of necessary joints. So providing joints and proper curing, then equal reinforcement in both the direction, and consideration of shrinkage and expansion while designing should be necessary to avoid the cracking. Alright, now permissible stresses in concrete. You can see the chart. This chart is also available in IS 3370. This chart is also available in IS 456, you can see. Okay, for M15 the permissible stress in direct tension is 1.1, in tension due to bending it's 1.5, and permissible shear strain is 1.5. so as is, it is the chart which is very useful in the examination also, looking towards the numerical and given data, we need to assess properly by using the IS score, the exact value of M15, M20, M25, M30 and M35. So this is the permissible stress. The unit is Newton per mm square. Okay. This is all about the grade of concrete. Now, permissible stresses in the steel. Okay, this is also available in IS code. And in examination, these are the values which is very useful to solve the numerical, and that's why we need to assess properly in the examination. When with the help of IS code, we have to solve it, we have to get it. Then tensile stresses in the member under direct tension, sigma s, that is 115 for round steel, and for high yield strength deformed bars, HYSD is 150. So looking towards the condition, it is divided and value has been given. So our role is to identify properly the given data, and we need to pick the proper value from the IS code. This table is also given in the IS code. So this is all about the permissible stresses in steel. Previously we have seen permissible stresses in the concrete, and now it is the steel. All right. Now minimum reinforcement required. Basically, it is the clause given in IS code regarding the minimum reinforcement for thickness given to the slab, base slab. Okay. It should be 100 mm and minimum percentage of reinforcement should be 0.3. okay, if for example if we assume thickness from 100 mm to 450 mm, then it may be reduced linearly to 0.2, because in design numerical it's all about your assumption, but for assumption there should have been some logic. Okay, there should have been some logic. Then P minimum is 0.3 up to 100 for 100 mm thick sections, and P minimum is equal to 0.3 minus 0.1 into T minus 100 upon 450 minus 100. Alright, so where T lies between 100 to 450 mm. Alright, minimum reinforcement should be ensured in both direction. That is a very important thing, and just now we have seen in terms of tracking, it's very important. If thickness of section is more than 225 mm, the layer of bar are required near both the faces. This point needs to be considered and keep in mind. Okay, then method of analysis. You can see the load sharing diagram where load taken by the hoop action, where D, okay, A, B, C and D, where small h, capital H, okay, and rho. So these are the things, okay, which is related for the load distribution. Okay, there are several analysis method like bending theory, plate load theory, finite element analysis, but we commonly use approximate method of analysis for water tanks. In this method, it is assumed that in case of circular tank, 1/3 or 1 meter, whichever is greater, and for rectangular tanks from bottom, 1/4 or 1, whichever is greater, is predominantly under cantilever action. This basic assumption we need to understand. Rest of the wall is resting on the water pressure by forces develop in horizontal direction as shown in the figure. You can see that where small h is the level of water, capital H is the entire height of the water tank. Okay, so that is the distribution where load sharing is given. Then again in this method, the bottom height of the wall BP is designed as a cantilever fixed at B and subjected to triangular load given by area DBC. As shown in the figure, you can see the pressure triangle. Load at B is equal to small w into h, of course. Okay, then reinforcement for cantilever action is provided up to the height small h from inner face of the wall. Just now as told, small h is the level of water inside the water tank, capital H is the entire height of the water tank. So the advantage of this method is over the sophisticated method is that it's simple method. First of all, it is more practical and gives a feel of structural behavior. Confusion driven disasters caused due to mistakes of draftsman in understanding sign convention and analysis steps of other complex method can be avoided. Okay, this is very important. I would like to repeat once again that confusion driven disaster, just like mistakes by draftsman and understanding sign convention, it can be avoided by this method. So it is very important. Then rectangular tanks are provided when capacity required is less or small. Then for small capacities, circular tanks are uneconomical. Okay, on account of curved shuttering, thus rectangular tanks prove to be more economical. Okay. Unlike circular tanks, rectangular tanks occupy entire available area, so it is easy to divide the tank in compartments and design. This is also important point. Point number three is very important as far as cracking is concerned. It is very easy to divide in compartments and design. Okay. Now you can see in the photograph the typical example of the resting on the ground type of basics. As far as basic design is concerned, you can see the tank type water tank resting on ground in rectangular case. So first one is side wall, then base slab and roof slab. Okay, the design of wall by approximate method is broadly classified into two categories: tanks having ratio L by B less than 2 and L by B greater than 2, length by width. Okay, so it is categorized into two parts, where the ratio of length by breadth is less than 2, and second one is the ratio of length by breadth greater than 2. Okay, now in first case, when it is less than 2, then tanks is designed as horizontal slab all around, okay, B by W corners, okay, and subjected to horizontal load due to hydrostatic pressure from 0 at the top to edge by 4 or 1 above the base, whichever is more, as discussed just now. From bottom junction to height of edge by 4 or 1, whichever is more, the wall is treated as vertical cantilever, okay, as shown in the figure. You can see that fixed at the base, maximum pressure, all right, is equals to small w into capital H, stands for entire height of the water tank, minus small h for water level at D point. You can see D point, and D dash and D is there. Okay, so from this you can calculate the maximum cantilever moment, okay, from the base. The formula is given. Okay, the pressure is resisted by the closed frame action in the tank, okay, and the fixed end moment at A at PB square by 12 and PL square by 12 using moment distribution method, they can be easily balanced. So you can see that the pressure diagram, okay, in which the load distribution and fixed end moments are given, where in the AB direction it is PL square by 12 and at P and at AD direction it is PHB square by 12, where the triangular diagram, pressure distribution diagram is also given. So it can be clearly understood that the load taken by the cantilever action, okay, so from the bottom of junction the height to edge by 4 or 1, whichever is more, and hence the wall, you can see the wall can be treated, the wall can be treated as the fixed cantilever base, okay, and this side you can see A to B, the fixed end moment is this, and then A to D, the fixed end moment is this one, okay, and it is a closed frame, you can see it's a closed frame, okay. Now in second case, if the length by breadth ratio is greater than 2, okay, first one we have seen, okay, in the same case, okay, the same case continue, then pull on the long wall and then pull on the short wall. We can see the difference in the first case only, that difference of the pressure on long walls and short walls. See, in the long walls, since the short wall span is B by W, long walls above D, the water pressure in short wall gets transferred to long walls as tensions. Okay, considering 1 meter height strip of the short wall at small h, total tension is equal to small w into height of the tank minus height of water level into 1 into B. Okay, and then pull on each wall TL, and then TL is equal to half into W into, in bracket, height of the entire water tank minus height of the water level into breadth B. Okay, it is somewhat different in case of short walls. In the similar fashion, long walls support the short walls and water pressure get transferred into short wall as tension. Okay, considering 1 meter high strip of the long wall at height H, so total tension is equals to small w into, as I told, capital H is equals to height of the water tank minus height of the water level into L into L, where in case of the long wall it is B, now it is L. Okay, So by this way you can calculate the pull on short and long wall. Okay. Now in second case where the ratio of length to breadth is more than 2, okay, in that case long walls are treated as vertical cantilever which is fixed at the base, and short walls are treated as horizontal slabs bending horizontally, okay, and B by W between the long walls, okay. Maximum bending moment in long walls is equals to half of W into H square into H by 3 is equals to WH cube by 6, okay. For short walls, maximum bending moment at level P may be taken under, okay. You can see the formulas are given here. Then to calculate the pull on long wall, pull on, okay, short wall, nothing but the forces, okay. And assume that the water pressure on about 1 meter of long wall adjusted to corner causes tension in short wall, okay. Many assumptions are need to be taken while designing, okay. So by this way, in second case that where ratio of length to breadth is more than 2, so these are the formulas, these are the terms, okay, which were used. Now tank wall section subjected to combined effect of bending moment and tension. So you can see the cross section of the tank which is subjected to combined bending moment and tension, in which distance of main reinforcement from central axis, okay, it is x, the effect of horizontal tensile force is to reduce the net moment in the walls. Thus final horizontal design moment, that is m dash tx, okay, that is the in x direction, okay, the bending moment reduces towards top of the edge, hence spacing may be increased toward the top. There is a scope of increase the spacing in the top, okay. Near corners bending moment is on inner face, and near center it is on outer side. Area of steel for net bending moment, that is AT is equals to m minus tx into divided by lever arm into safe stressing steel, okay. And area of steel for pull, okay, that is force A, that is, okay, and T by safe stressing steel, and then total area of steel is equals to net area of steel for net bending moment plus that is the area, okay. Then after the rectangular, just see the photographs first to understand the circular tank. These are the cases where tanks are resting on ground. Basically it is simple as compared to the rectangular, okay, and for same capacity in construction required less concrete than rectangular tanks, but it is economical for large capacity only, okay, and as preferably people prefer the rectangular tank only for large for small kind of, you know, storage, and it is only economical for a huge kind of storage, large capacity of storage. So on account of circular shape, it can be made water tight easily as there is no sharp corners, okay. That problem is not here. So for purpose of design, circular tanks can be divided into following two categories: tanks with sliding or flexible joint between the floors and walls, and circular tanks with rigid joint between floors and walls, okay. Now with flexible joint between floor and wall, okay, you can see the joint here, okay. This is the steel plating and this is the sliding surface of rubber pad, and this is the joint ceiling compared, okay. So in this case, the wall is free to move outward when internal water pressure is applied. Hence the wall is subjected to hoop stress T only, and T is equals to, okay. So you can see the steel plating and the sliding surface of the rubber, okay. So by this formula you can calculate the hoop stresses, oh, and the maximum where you can calculate the point where the maximum hoop stress occurs, okay, which is at h by 3 or 1, whichever is more, okay. Now with rigid base we can see, since the wall in this case is fixed with floor slab, circumferential elongation of the wall is not possible at its junction with floor slab. Hence, hoop stress is zero there, and the entire liquid pressure is resisted by cantilever action. At certain point D, at the height H above base slab, full hoop stress develop and cantilever effect is zero. At the midway between D and base slab, liquid pressure is resisted partly by hoop action and partly by cantilever action. Then you can see figure A shows likely deformation of the wall, where figure B shows load distribution in the wall, and figure C shows the bending moment of the diagram of the wall. Okay, so since the wall in this case is fixed, okay, the circumferential elongation of the wall is not possible at junction with floor slab, hence the hoop stress, okay, is zero there. You know, at midway you can see that the between the D and the base slab, liquid pressure is resisted partially by hoop action, and at certain point D, there at the height H above the base slab, full hoop stress developed and cantilever effect is also zero. Okay, now design constants we should know depth of neutral axis, then lever arm, then small j, moment of resistance m, k. So there are the some constants, and the definition of the constants, you know, are available in the IS code. Okay, modular ratio, and then m, small m. Okay, so these are the things we must know while starting any numericals. So what is small k and all, so these are the all the things are available in IS 3370 as well as in IS 456 2000. Okay, now view for rectangular water tank. So such kind of diagrams can be drawn in AutoCAD, and you can see that the view for rectangular water tank. Okay, so this practical problem we will consider and we will solve, then such kind of diagrams will be useful for us. Okay, so this is a basic basic introduction and basic thing we have seen regarding the rectangular tanks and water tanks, where I just want to give you recap of all the things. In the rectangular tanks, we have seen two basic criteria, where length to breadth ratio is less than 2 or more than 2. Okay, and we have seen different parameters for designing. And in circular tanks, we have seen the tanks with sliding or flexible joint between the floors and walls, and then second one is rectangular tank with rigid joints. Okay, and in further class we will talk about the design problems. Okay, I have considered some designs. So what are the reinforcement criteria, how to design, and how to consider the slab, what are the basic assumption, which is the shorter, which is the longer. So this kind of thing we will continue in the next our classes, further lectures. So at this point I would like to stop, and just want to brief that we have seen the basic introduction, basic applicability, and basic things regarding the water tanks, especially of two types, that is rectangular and flexible. Okay, and the classification is very important to know that the class these tanks are classified on the basis of, you know, their placement and on the basis of their shape. So on the placement, above the ground, underground, and at the top, and on the shape, that is rectangular, you can see circular, okay, spherical, ends, and combined. Okay, so with this I would like to stop here, and I'm showing you the reference books. You must have it, also the IS code copy also you must have. Okay, with this I'll say thank you. Okay, thank you very much.